Today we are going to read a famous sonnet, Asleep in the Valley, composed by Arthur Rimbaud. The full name of the poet was Jean Nicholas Arthur Rimbaud. He was born on 20th October 1854 at Surlevel in France. His father Frederick Rimbaud was an infantry captain, and Rimbaud himself was a soldier in the Dutch colonial army in 1876. So he had a first-hand experience of war. This present poem, which was written in French, titled Le Dormeur Le Fol, is an anti-war poem. In this poem, the poet shows the futility of war. He indicates that war can only destroy a youthful life, which could otherwise survive and lead a peaceful life. This is a Petrarchan sonnet, divided into octave and sestet. The octave part consists of two stanzas of four lines each, and the sestet part consists of two stanzas of three lines each. The poem is written in free verse, as it does not follow the consistent metrical patterns or rhyme scheme. This type of verse was created in the last 19th century in France. Before we go to read the poem, we should have some ideas about symbolism, surrealism and dadaism, as we shall see these ideas are prevailed all over the poem. Symbolism. Etymologically, the term symbolism is derived from the Latin term symbolum. Symbolism means the use of symbols to represent one's ideas. In this poem, Asleep in the Valley, Arthur Rimbaud presents the scenic beauty, the soldier, his death with various symbols. Surrealism. Surrealism was a cultural movement, aim of which was to settle the earlier contradictory situations, as for example, dream and reality, into an absolute reality. It is an artistic attempt to connect both the reality and imagination. Dadaism. Dadaism was an art movement in the early 20th century in Europe. It was founded on the principle of apathy towards the accepted aesthetic criteria. They glorified luck or irrationality on the place of logic or calculated intention. There is a contradiction among the critics about the creation of the poem. As Arthur Rimbaud became a soldier in the Dutch colonial army in 1876, some critics think that the poem was written from the poet's own experience. Others think that this poem is the product of his own imagination. As we go through the poem, we shall see that the poem is divided into three parts. The first part presents a beautiful landscape. Amid the beauty of nature, a soldier is lying. The second part deals with some confusion. Though the soldier is lying in a comfortable atmosphere and his smile is innocent and gentle like an infant, he is pale. And this is a contrast with the lively, picturesque view. The third part of the poem, there prevails a sadness. Here the word asleep is used metaphorically. As the soldier was asleep, not to awake again, he is dead. Thus the poet indicates the horror of war. Mother Nature, with all her comfort, cannot revive the young soldier who could otherwise contribute to the prosperity of the world. But the war has destroyed his life. So we see the poet has a critical view of war and criticizes it as the barrier of happy and peaceful life in this beautiful world. Now we shall go to analyze the poem line by line. A small green valley where a slow stream flows. In the very first line of the poem, the poet presents a very beautiful landscape. It is a valley. Valley means a low area of land between hills or mountains. Here the valley is beautiful, as it is covered with green grass and a slow river flows there and leaves long strands of silver on the bright grass. Long strands here means long strips In the dazzling sunlight, the river and its beach looks like a long silvery ribbon, and even our green grasses brightened. Here the mountain tops stream the sun's rays, they fill the hollow full of light. Here hollow refers to the valley. The sun's rays, like a stream, comes from the mountain top to the green valley and fills the valley with light. The entire valley looks bright and lively. A soldier, very young, lies open-mouthed. In this second stanza, the poet shows an anxiety, a confusion, which is a contrast from the first stanza. Here in this line, the poet says that a very young aged soldier is lying in the valley and his mouth is opened, a pillow made of fern beneath his head. Mother Nature has showed mercy to the soldier, so to give him comfort, he has provided him a pillow, which is made of fern, under his head. Asleep, stretched in the heavy undergrowth. Here undergrowth means bushes that grow in plenty in the valley. Here the poet says that the soldier's body is stretched upon the bed made by bushes, so he has got enough comfort, pale in his warm, green, sun-soaked bed. The sun has poured its rays to the entire valley, and the soldier's bed also has become warm and bright green colored. But here is a contrast. The soldier was very young, and his bed and pillow are sun-soaked, but he is pale. Here the poet reflects an apprehension in this stanza. His feet among the flowers, he sleeps, his smile is like an infant's, gentle without guile. Where the soldier is lying, there is plenty of flowers, and his feet are among the flowers, as if the nature is giving her honor to the dead soldier for his sacrifice for his motherland. There is a smile on his face, and the smile is innocent. There is no trickery on his smile. Here in this line, the poet wanted to show that the dead soldier has no complexity, so his smile is innocent. Oh, nature, keep him warm. He may catch cold. Here the poet implores the nature to keep the soldier warm, as he may catch cold. So here we see the poet has a soft corner for the soldier, so he wanted to keep him safe. The humming insects don't disturb his rest. Humming insects made a droning noise, so the poet forbids the insects to disturb his rest. The soldier is lying peacefully, so the poet does not want anything to disturb his sleep. He sleeps in sunlight, one hand on his breast, at peace. In his side, there are two dead horses. The soldier is sleeping in the sunlight, and his one hand is on his breast, shows how peacefully he is sleeping. But at the end line, the reader gets a sudden shock to see that there are two red holes made by the bullet from the enemy on the side of the soldier. Thus the poem is ended with the discovery of the death of the soldier. In this anti-war poem, the poet indicates what a war can do to the mankind. It cannot produce any good, but can destroy a beautiful life very easily.